Hello, I'm a member of the Yale Drop Team, a group of undergraduates at Yale University that performs microgravity research under the auspices of a NASA education program managed by Johnson Space Center. My rap crew and I are here to tell you about our experience with the Reduced Gravity Student Flight Opportunities Program and our experiment, which involves complex plasma and microgravity. We're students of science, but this crew's more than that. We've got freshmen and seniors, geoscience and math, high-pressure physics,
colliders,
astronomy.
I study clay cracking without an apology.
What's a plasma, you say? Argon ions and electrons go their separate ways. Put dust in the mix, and what do you find? A crystalline structure that will blow your mind.
Manufacturing nebulae and ISM, dusty plasmas abound all up in them. So our research is useful in myriad ways. Ask Joe about it, he could go on for days.
Dusty plasmas are ubiquitous in the universe, intrinsic to everything from heliophysics to the dynamics of planetary accretion. Our research also has application to industry, where dust can contaminate various manufacturing processes. Furthermore,
hold up!
How do you study plasma in the lab?
With a high-speed camera and whatever else you know. Write up our proposal, send it off to NASA, then fly on G+1 and get you some answers.
G-Force 1 is a Boeing 727 that flies multiple parabolic arcs over the Gulf of Mexico to create brief conditions of microgravity within the cabin. The flight profile begins with a 2G, or hypergravity, pull-up. When the plane reaches a 45-degree climb, it begins to follow a ballistic trajectory. During this portion of a flight path, periods of microgravity exist within the cabin. When the plane reaches a 30-degree dive, the pilots again pull up, creating another 2G portion of the flight.
Down the argon to 200 millitor. At 1200 FPS, we get data galore.
The scientific goal of our experiment centered on an attempt to image obliquely propagating high-frequency, self-excited dust density waves in a complex argon plasma. Hey, what are you doing? Various interesting crystalline structures, notably a central void, have been observed during experiments aboard the International Space Station. Our hardware was explicitly designed to replicate such studies.
What you gotta do before you can fly past NASA inspections, where you better not lie. They check out your stuff, and so we are told, they're just making sure the plane don't explode. New kids are taught how not to get sick, and stuffed into a chamber where the air ain't so thick. At FL250, you can get kinda hypoxic, but it don't even matter, cause the drop team rocks it.
Actually, I had to be dragged to the emergency airlock. But really, the experience is perfectly safe, thanks to many wonderful NASA personnel. Symptoms of hypoxia are highly individual, and in the unique operational environment of zero-gravity flight, it pays to know what yours are. NASA prepares all of its flyers with extensive, but entertaining and educational, classroom training about the human body's responses to disorienting accelerations and other stimuli.
The day comes, the drop team invades. We jump in our flight suits and we show off our shades. We all board the plane, our shoulders up straight. The time has to come to determine our fate. Once the ride starts, you best prepare. 30 seconds by 30 is all the time in the air. Time to get data, we run without scenes. The drop team is golden, a well-oiled machine.
Gravity is out, like proof true polar wonder beyond any doubt.
legendary research brings science to the public, and back on our ground, our reach program's sick.
Not all of our time is spent in the lab. We travel to school and show how science is back. Through pictures and talks, we spread knowledge hardcore. We want kids to have fun and learn even more.
So that's our story. It's been long enough. Straight zero G's, and it's time to lift
off of discovery and a team of explorers shaping their destiny.